Religion and evolution mix like water and oil-covered cats. They just don't seem to get along. But is it possible we evolved to have religion? Hey, believers and skeptics, Julian here for D News. Recently, a study published in the journal Social Cognitive and Affective Neuroscience examined how a certain part of the brain is linked to belief in God. The study used 39 college undergraduates who were all religious and politically moderate. They were split into two groups. The first group had their posterior medial frontal cortex, or PMFC, PMFC, temporarily inhibited with pulses from a transcranial magnet. And the second group got a similar treatment, but with the magnet turned down, so it didn't actually affect how their brain worked. The participants were first primed with a discussion on death, and then asked whether they believed in various aspects of religion. The devil, hell, God, heaven. Those who had their brain inhibited reported believing in all that almost a third less often than the students in the uninhibited group. The conclusion the researchers drew is religion could be a method for overcoming an ideological problem. You see, according to the researchers, the PMFC they were tinkering with is used for solving concrete problems, like figuring out the best way to climb over a fallen log. It perceives a problem, determines the threat, and then decides a course of action. So, the scientists from the University of York and UCLA wanted to see if the same hardware was implemented when a person is confronted with the knotty problem of death. Death is scary and inevitable, so our brains need a way to cope with that. This echoes what some other scientists believe about religion. In 2008, prominent atheist Richard Dawkins was asked if religion must give humans some evolutionary advantage, considering how ubiquitous it is across culture and history. Dawkins responded that he did indeed believe that humans had evolved to believe in God, but that it was a byproduct of mental machinery that was advantageous in some other way. He compared it to a moth's tendency to fly into a candle flame because they evolved to use bright but distant light sources like the moon to navigate, and a candle confused what had been useful for their survival for millions of years before artificial light. Self-immolation is clearly a bad survival strategy for a moth, so it's easy to write that off as some other biological function being co-opted. But it's possible believing in a higher power helps our species. In a 2006 study published in the Journal of Developmental Psychology, psychologist Jesse Baring devised an experiment where he challenged children to play a game that was impossible to win without cheating. For a third of the children, each child played by themselves with no supervision. For another third, a researcher stayed in the room with them, and for the last group, they were told that there was a magical invisible princess who would be there watching them play. The result was the unsupervised children cheated way more, and the ones who believed a presence was there cheated about as often as when an actual adult was sitting right behind them. Baring repeated the experiment with adults, though presumably he didn't tell them a magical princess was there, and the results were about the same. The thinking goes that if we believe we're being watched and judged, we all benefit. Professor Dominic Johnson of the University of Edinburgh likened it to riding the subway. In order for the subway to function, we all have to pay. If one person cheats and doesn't pay, sure, they have given themselves a little advantage, but if too many people do it, the whole system collapses. It's possible there are other explanations for why dialing down the posterior medial frontal cortex made participants say they were less religiously inclined. The same study also found that those with their brains inhibited were more accepting of immigrants criticizing their country. A 2011 study in the Journal of Neuroscience found that similarly inhibited participants conformed to social norms less. And another study in the journal from earlier this year showed that the PMFC keeps us making choices that are consistent with ones made in the past. So, maybe this part of the brain, along with helping us solve problems, preserves how we've learned to solve them before, and so keeps religious beliefs rigid. To quote the researchers of the original study themselves, more research is needed. Like it or not, religion is an essential part of the human story. You've got your own story too, and no domain extension will help you tell it like a .com or .net domain name from domain.com. And because you watch DNews, you can get 15% off domain.com's names and web hosting by using the code DNews when you check out. The topic of God and science is a great one. There's so much to talk about, we couldn't possibly do it in one episode. So, Trace devoted an entire week to discussing it over on Test Tube Plus. Check it out right here.
And they recognize that scientific ideas must be capable of being overturned, and evidence and experimentation and observation are going to change science over time. But there's room for God in all of this stuff for these people.
This is normally the part where I'd say something to get you involved in talking, but I know for this episode, I don't have to. Just remember to keep it civil, even if you believe there's no higher power watching. We're all human beings, people. Let's work together for the benefit of the species. Subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time on D News. We'll be right back.